and others. And the third part is regarding the US-Egyptian financial aid and the way to cooperate between the two countries and resume this relations to make sure that Egypt, as an important ally for Washington, would carry out its mission and role in the near future.
Right. Dr. Hamza, well, U.S. President Barack Obama described the relationship with Egypt, the long-standing relationship between the United States and Egypt, as the cornerstone of the American security policy for the region.
This is true. First, if we revise the statement of President Obama from 2 days ago when he spoke about the part related to Egypt, he mentioned that Mohamed Morsi was a president who was elected democratically, but he was not able or capable to apply a democratic governance. So this is some kind of a new confession of the United States as a corrective approach with the Egyptian government to declare that the current Egyptian government is a legitimate government that are supported by the people, and we have a non-transition process. United States understands the value of Egypt in the Middle East in any kind of security related, especially in part related to logistics, to on-ground troops, to intelligence, and so on. And this was proved since a long time ago, especially on the Iraqi war, that Egypt was a big part from the ground forces that entered Kuwait and entered, we didn't enter Iraq, but we entered Kuwait. Now in the campaign for make an ally for coalition against Daesh in the Middle East, U.S. was successfully able to convince the Saudi Arabias and the rest of the GCC countries. Egypt said that we are going to support fighting terrorism, but we are not going to send ground forces, which I am fully supporting this, because also we have to take care of our national security, because we have a lot of problems surrounding us, so we cannot currently send a full deployed ground forces inside Syria or Iraq, because this will have different consequences around us. But I see now that the U.S. are very, very interested to rebuild the relation again with Egypt, and this was reflected on the meeting request of Mr. Obama with the Sisi. This was reflected in his speech in front of the United Nations. He mentioned that we are going to cooperate in the support financial aid to Egypt, especially for education and economical cooperation. There are still some concerns regarding the military aid between the U.S. And Egypt. This is for different political pressures technique. But I think Egypt also is very aware of what is happening, so we have different sources of military aid now, or different sources of military support that we are using, like Russia and maybe China and so on. So this is in summary that without availability of Egypt in such type of counterterrorism or for deploying security in Middle East, it will be very, very hard.
Right. Dr. Yasser, the U.S. interest in rebuilding the relationship with Egypt, how far was it clarified what has happened in June 30th revolution?
In fact, the way I read the U.S.-Egyptian relations, maybe it's totally different from what it is usually presented in Egypt for the last few months. I think there is always some tension between Egypt and U.S., but it never reached the hatred or the conspiracy theory which is usually promoted. Mm-hmm. I think there were some differences which makes sense, because the U.S. has its own way or vision of the democracy, or even the way of elections and things like that. And for example, Obama's administration never uttered the C-word coup in its discourse regarding the Egyptian events and developments in the last few months since decisions of 3rd of July 2013. The problem is they have two concerns which make sense for the U.S. discourse and policies regarding democracy. the transition of democracy, and I think they came out to understand this in from our Egyptian point of view, and the human rights things. Mm-hmm. I think the human rights maybe is the one big problem which is facing the relations between the two countries currently, and they are coming over this problem by discussion and even transparency in tackling this problem, whether between President Sisi and President Obama in this meeting tonight, and through the diplomatic channels between Cairo and Washington. So I think it's important to understand that this is a kind of giving a push forward for the relation between two countries, but it never came to a rock for the last few months. There were some problems, yes, there are some problems. The Congress pushing, and don't forget that U.S. is not only one concrete policy, it's distributed, and from different points of view, the Congress pushing, some congressmen are pushing against resuming the financial and military aid to Egypt, but again, the Washington D.C., the White House is looking upon the Egyptian rule with a great importance and appreciation, and that Egypt is a key ally which can play a key role in fighting terrorism and even helping the Palestinian-Israeli negotiations and other key issues in the region.
Right. Well, the presidential spokesman, Alaa Youssef, noted that President Obama usually does not hold those meetings on the sidelines of the UN General Assembly. So it reflects a sense of keenness of changing course towards
it is
Egypt,
a
isn't it?
Change, yes, because normally he doesn't meet during the UN meetings, and he was insisting and he requested this meeting. So there is a switch or shift in the U.S. Relation. This can be as a result for the successful international relation of Egypt, if is it? And as we can see that from international relation point of view, we have done a very big step in this UN summit, because President Sisi have insisted that any kind of relation or cooperation should be based on mutual respect and mutual benefit and equal relation. So when President Obama was speaking about supporting Israel in the Middle East, and we are going to continue support Israel in the Middle East, President Sisi was not shy to say that we are going to support the Palestinian, and the Palestinian have rights. So this is reflecting that we are equal partners, we are not a less or little partners compared to what used to be before. So I see there is a strong shift on the relation between U.S. and Egypt. Mm-hmm. Also, during the visit of President Sisi and the Egyptian delegates, a lot of other countries like David Cameron and Holland and so on have met President Sisi. The Egyptian side have able somehow successfully to reflect what is really happening on Egypt, despite the fact that there are other parties or groups that were interested to try to make some obstacle or try to destroy the image of the Egyptian during the UN meetings, like some kind of counter-campaigns organized by the Brotherhood, by preventing Egyptian journalists and the delegates from arriving in the New York airport, but this was not successful. Also, we find even Qatar in their speech in the United Nations, they didn't mention directly Egypt or try to attack Egypt to be political. Despite the fact they highlighted that the model of Tunisia is the best one, okay, but there was more smarter campaign with Mr. Erdogan, because I believe he is, I don't understand, but as a diplomacy ethics, he is far away from understanding the diplomacy ethics, because how far you have a conflict with any country, you should keep some kind of exit window, you should keep some kind of relation. Because
and the door open.
And the door open, because Egypt and Turkey are strategic allies. So he is taking it too much personal, okay? And he feels that he lost a lot of prestige and a lot of support and so on. So he's taking too much arrogance and taking too much person. And it was not very appreciated by the delegate or the attending people. And even a lot of fun and jokes are happening about Mr. Erdogan on the social media. So if you want to summarize the success of international relation of any or foreign policy of any country, it should be summarized that if this country is successful to increase their allies and reduce its enemies, this is as a good indicator for their foreign affairs and their responsibility. So now we see that Egypt somehow reduced their enemies and able to increase their allies. Even past enemies in the last 2 years are becoming now allies like the US. On the other hand, you'll find Turkey is some kind isolated, so most of their allies and most of their partners in the Middle East somehow are separated from them. Even Qatar are trying to open door, not to lose everything and not to be in one side. So on the foreign policy side, Egypt is very, very successful so far. The United States is smart enough to re-coordinate and understand the value of the Egyptian government. Turkey is so far is depending on a personal approach, not a strategic approach for the sake of the Turkish Republic. Qatar is also trying to open some kind of doors to keep it balanced.
Okay, Turkey putting banners, Dr. Thabet.